In this video, I want to talk about what kind of native file format to use for Outlook emails. Should you use MSG or HTML to save your native files? When you load data for processing, you have to make that decision usually upfront. In some software, you can adjust it at the export time, but when you're doing processing in law or relativity, you would have to select that when you're loading your PSTs into your processing software for review. So what options should you choose? First, let's talk about law pre-discovery and see what options it offers. When you go to EDLoader and select email section, you'll see that there are five different options available. You have an HTML, HTML/MHT, MHT, and you have an MSG option. When you're using relativity processing, it only supports MSG files. If you are a Relativity One Cloud customer, this option you see on the screen of MHT should be available to you. For the rest of us, that option is coming in 2018, which is probably in January or February. So let's talk in details what all these options mean and how they work. So first one is HTML. HTML just takes your email, saves it in a HTML format, and if there are any inline pictures, they will be saved separately and the link will be created to them from inside an HTML file. Now, in my opinion, it's a terrible option to select. It will just make an absolute mess if you using this in law pre-discovery. You will have extra files, so when you're doing your file counts check for production, your native files will not line up with your number of lines in a dat file. It just makes a mess. Next option is HTML/MHTML. Now, this is a good option to use. It will save text-based emails or emails without any images as an HTML, and if there are embedded images, it will make an MHTML file or MHT, and it'll embed all the pictures right inside the image. So that's a good option. Next option is HTML RTF. Similar to a previous one, if there are any emails with pictures in them, it'll make an RTF file, and it will use RTF as a file format for that email. The two problems with it, feels like RTF is overly complicated file storage format and it's not really needed here. Also, BCC information doesn't get saved in a RTF, so that's also kind of a downside of that, so I would not use that option. If I were to use an HTML-based format, I would use the fourth one, which is MHTML or MHT, and that's my personal preference. All the emails will get saved in the MHT file format. If there are any pictures, they'll be preserved. If not, it's still going to be an MHT. The reason why I like it is it's consistent. You don't have some emails HTML, some MHT, you get one file format and done. And this is what Relativity is going to do when they bring MHT support to on-prem version of Relativity, or if you have a cloud, you already have it. It's just gonna be MHT consistent for all the emails. And the last option here on the list is MSG. Now, MSG is a native format for Outlook emails. It preserves as much of email as possible. It saves all the metadata, it saves everything, and nothing, there is no conversion process that happens, just the entire email gets saved. So let's talk about pros and cons of an HTML-based format, which is the top first, second, and fourth, versus MSG, which is the last one. So what are some of the pros of an HTML-based format? Well, it's smaller. So you're only storing email text and a header. You're not storing anything else that you don't see. You get better control over your metadata because you don't have any metadata that's hidden. You get exactly what's on your screen. And the fact that attachments are not being saved inside that HTML file allows you to produce partial families. So if you don't want to produce certain family members, you can certainly exclude that. The downside of an HTML-based file format is there is a conversion happens. So when you convert from MSG into an HTML, you drop in a lot of metadata, you basically throwing everything out except what you see on the screen. And because it's a conversion process, you may get different conversion errors. Sometimes email headers get messed up, which is very, very infrequent, but I've seen it happen a few times. Let's talk about MSG files next. Some of the pros of MSGs. Well, as we saw before, MSGs preserve all metadata. Nothing is lost. Every piece of metadata about email is saved with the MSG file itself. So when you're using that as a native file format, you're saving as much metadata as possible. The next point is MSG files are sort of live emails. So when you open them on different computers with different time zones, the date and time automatically adjusts to a user's computer. So if you want to see an email in a different time zone, you just change the time zone on your computer and it'll update automatically. And if you ever need to rebuild a PST, you can certainly do it from MSG files because we did not discard any metadata. All the metadata is in MSG, and if we want to, we can just drag and drop it back into Outlook and rebuild pretty much original PST. The downsides of MSG is it's a live email. So if you accidentally hit reply or forward button, it will get emailed. It will get sent to the people in the email header. So you need to be very careful with it. MSG is also much larger because it stores all the email attachments inside that MSG file. And having attachments in there limits your flexibility as to what you can do with an email. If you want to produce partial families, you will not be able to do so. And finally, there's lots and lots of metadata that we were able to preserve, but you may not be able to see it. If we use application like an Outlook Spy, we can see that there are tons and tons of fields that are stored inside of MSG file. And if you ever to produce that MSG file natively, you let in somebody else poking that metadata that you potentially have never seen and maybe find something that you don't know exists there. Anyway, if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, share with your coworkers, subscribe to see more videos, and click bell to be notified when I upload more videos. And finally, put in the description if you like this video or if you have suggestions for other videos I should make. Thank you for watching.